Last week, I threw my husband a 30th birthday party, and this was the food spread. I planned out the entire menu, and my family helped prepare most of the foods.
We made a bunch of finger foods like falafel, schnitzel sandwiches, sushi, and impossible vegan sliders.
Tons of dips and salads, different savory pastries filled with potatoes or lentils, deli roll, chicken tenders, and a bunch of different salads. For dessert, there were different nuts, gummy candies, fruit salad cups, an Oreos and cream 30th birthday cake that took me like 2 days to make, but I'm so happy with how it turned out. I topped it with some fresh fruit, cookies, chocolates, and mini alcohol bottles. There were also Rice Krispie treats, chocolate chip cookies, and vegan donuts.
You must follow food TikTok. Knowing how to make food from a box is not good enough. Knowing how to order food online is not impressive. Come to food TikTok and I will show you how to cook such amazing food that
موزة هاتي رقمك قولي رقمك زيرو كام بحبك
These are ham and cheese roll-ups. It is always a party favorite. And the most important thing, it is cheap. Let me show you how easy it is to make it. Start by removing the edges from the bread. Then use anything you have to press it down. You want it as flat as possible. Add a little bit of ham and cheese and roll everything together. As you can see, it takes no time at all. Now the only thing left to do is to get it breaded. And regardless of what type of breading you like, make sure you season that well. For me, I just added a little bit of black pepper, followed by Korean chili flakes, oregano, basil, and salt. Mix it well and my breadcrumbs were ready. Then throw them in an egg wash so that they can get nice and sticky. Because now you want to make sure that the breadcrumb sticks. Keep doing until you have all of them ready, as you want to deep fry them at 325 degrees Fahrenheit. Get that done until they get nice golden brown, just like this. That is how easy it is to make these delicious cheesy roll-ups. And they are amazing. Go make some, you'll thank me later.
I don't know about you, but I feel better when I'm dancing. Yeah, yeah. I'm better when I'm dancing. Yeah, yeah. And we can do this together. I bet you feel better when you're dancing.
Goodness gracious, this thing took up every single one of my 120 nuggets. Fill in with some cherry tomato ornaments. For those tougher to reach spots, we'll add some pickle chips. And finally, a few sprigs of rosemary for a little greenery. And we'll finish it off with a show-stopping pepper jack star. Now our tree is decorated, but has no gifts. So what better than some gift-wrapped dipping sauces? This is the ultimate holiday food decoration. And anybody could make it. It was so easy. That's one way to one-up your neighbors.
This delicious appetizer bite has only 4 ingredients. To make it, you'll need puff pastry dough, brie cheese, cranberry sauce, and an orange. Coat a mini muffin pan with nonstick cook spray. Roll the thawed puff pastry dough out onto a floured surface. Using a pizza cutter, cut the dough into 24 2.5-inch squares. Press the squares into the cups of the prepared mini muffin pan. Prick with the tines of a fork. Next, it's time to cube your brie. It's easier to cut soft cheeses like brie if you freeze it for about 15 minutes before you're ready to cut it. Place a 1/2-inch cube of brie in each cup, followed by about a teaspoon of the cranberry sauce. Add a bit of fresh orange zest to the top of each cup. Bake at 375 degrees for about 15 minutes or until the pastry is puffed and the corners are golden brown. Cool on a wire rack for a few minutes before transferring to a serving platter. Enjoy and follow Fab every day for more easy party ideas like this.
We are headed to a pool party later, and I am taking one of my husband's favorite dips. It is a crowd pleaser. You're gonna wanna drain 2 to 3 cans of crisp sweet corn. Then you're gonna wanna get 1 cup of mayo. I always use the regular mayo. 2 to 4 diced jalapenos, depending on how hot you want it. A bunch of chopped green onions. 2 to 3 cups of Colby Jack cheese. Garlic powder to taste. I always use quite a bit. Also pepper to taste. Give it a nice stir. Pop it in the fridge and pair it with Tostitos scoops, and it is so delicious.
Add 17 videos to the sound and let TikTok sync it.
How good are cob loaves? How good are mini cobs? Let me show you how I make mine. So I do a cheese and bacon one with some garlic. So cook up your bacon. I also cut up some spring onions. And as for the cheese mix, I use thickened cream. I use Philly cream cheese. I use a mix of mozzarella and cheddar cheese and give that all a good mix in together. I also add garlic powder. And then I add some pepper. I put together some bacon and spring onion. And because I was going to a get together, I put it into a container to take it with me, so it was travel worthy. Into the mini cobs, I just sort of take out the center, get them all nice and beautiful looking like so. And I use the leftover middle bits to use to dip in any leftover dip.
Hi, my name is Karen and I'm a private chef. At tonight's event for 80 people, we started off with torch salmon nigiris and spicy tuna crispy rice. After hors d'oeuvres, entrees were served in 3 stations. A Peking duck station with dipping sauces and toppings, a skewer station with vegetables, salmon, steak, and chicken, and lastly, a build-your-own poke bowl station. This event was so fun to execute. Comment what videos you want to see next.
Y'all, today my daughter came downstairs and she said, "Mama, why are you cooking party food? What's the celebration?" I said, "I'm celebrating me, celebrating putting myself first." She said, "Well, what you did? Bought yourself something? I ain't see you buy yourself nothing." I said, "No, I called in to work and it felt too damn good."
Two cans of crescent roll dough, some sausage and cream cheese, and you got a delicious snack. Show you what it's all about. You got 1 block of cream cheese in the bowl. You need 1 package of breakfast sausage. Go ahead and brown it up. Then I'm adding some dehydrated garlic flakes and some onion flakes. We're just gonna mix it up with a fork. Gonna grease up a little casserole dish so it don't stick. And we're gonna put our crescent roll dough in the bottom. Now we're gonna add the sausage mixture and just spread it out. And we're gonna add jalapenos right to the top, as many or as few as you like. And we're gonna pop top layer, crescent dough. Same thing, just roll it out right on top. Now we're going on the pellet grill, 350 degrees, till it's nice and brown on top. These spicy sausage squares is ready. We're gonna take a big knife, cut this dude into squares. You gotta have something to dip it in. I got a little bit of Captain Rodney's peach bouquet glaze. Love the cream cheese, the sausage, the jalapenos in it. Going in the Captain Rodney's to give it a little sweet tang.
We're at a family party and they have oysters. They have crab claws. Like fire flames. I don't know how to get this out. Obviously Caesar salad. What's up, balls? These stuffed hot peppers. Tomato mozzarella with ragout on it. More oysters.
Stay munching.
कैसे ये मोहब्बत मेरी सब दिल वाले कर के खुला से आया मैं कल माही दिया खाना अखा चार हो गई उठे
let's get down to business give you one more night to get this We've had a million nights just like this So let's get down to business let's get down to business Give you one more night to get this We've had a million nights just like this So let's get down to business Back and forth with the